Oh. my father's back?
Your father is back.
And his boat back this very morning.
This very morning.
And he's come back determined to marry me off.
To marry you off?
To a daughter of Senor Geronte.
Of Senor Geronte.
And this daughter is on her way back from Marseille to do the deed.
To do the deed.
And this news was sent to me by my uncle.
By your uncle.
Who had it from my father in a letter.
In a letter?
And now my uncle knows all we've been up to.
All we've been up to.
For heaven's sake, say something instead of parroting everything I say.
Parroting every... What more can I say? You remembered everything spot on.
Well, at least give me some advice. Tell me how I can get out of this terrible mess.
Oi, Mama Leone. I'm just as much in the mess as you are. I can do with a bit of advice myself.
I'm ruined by this rotten return!
The ruin is mutual.
When my father finds out, I can see a thunderstorm of violent recriminations pouring out on me.
Excuse me? Recriminations pouring are nothing. It's me what'll have to suffer most. I can see a thunderstorm of belts on the ear pouring out on me!
God! How can I get out of this terrible mess that I'm in?
You should have thought of that one before you got yourself into it.
Now's not the time to say, I told you so. What can I do?
I don't know. What can I do?
I don't know. I can't swim.
Come out!
Senor Octavio?
Scapino?
Hey! What's wrong? What's the matter? Something seems to be wrong. You look a little disturbed.
My dear Scapino, I'm ruined. I'm going mad. I'm the unhappiest man in the whole world.
Really? How's that?
You mean to say you haven't heard what's happened to me?
Oh, you mean that the letter your uncle got from your father, who's returning home early. No.
My father and Senor Geronte are back, and they're determined to marry me off.
What's so horrible in that?
Only knew the cause of my troubles, Scapino.
Oh, there. Just you tell me everything. You know, I'm always willing to listen when a young fellow is in trouble. Always.
Dear Scapino, if you can devise any means for me to get out of this terrible mess that I'm in, I will be indebted to you for the rest of my life!
Yes. Well, there's not much that I can't do once I've set my mind to it. You see, the good Lord has blessed me with quite a genius for clever ideas and inspired adventures, which the less talented in their jealousies call deceit, trickery. But without a shadow of a doubt, there has never been another fellow who could measure up to me. What comes down to a little bit of fiddling or making a slight adjustment in a tight situation. Chocolate.
Thank you.
Chocolate? No? There's no one with a bad reputation at the job, but talent and hard work just aren't appreciated these days. And since my affairs got a little troubled, I've given the whole thing up.
What affairs and what troubles, Scapino?
Oh, I had a little contretemps with the law.
With the law?
Yes, we didn't quite agree on certain dear matter.
They didn't quite agree.
How have you know? They treated me quite badly in there. And I was so struck by the ingratitude of my fellow man, I vowed I would never lift another finger to help anyone ever again. But I'm always willing to listen.
You know, Scapino, that 2 months ago, Senor Geronte and my father set sail on a business trip in which both their interests were concerned.
Quite.
And that Leandro and myself were left by our fathers, myself in the care of Silvestro. and Leandro under your supervision.
And I did my job very conscientiously.
So did I.
No. Sometime later, Leandro met a young gypsy girl and fell madly in love with her.
Leandro, quite.
As we're great friends, he took me straight away into his confidence, and we went together to see the girl. Well, I thought she was quite pretty, but not as pretty as he thought.
Look!
He talked about nothing but her, day in, day out. Hardly a moment went by when he didn't talk about her beauty, her charm, her wit, her every word. In fact, he got quite annoyed with me because I wasn't as lovesick as he was.
Look! I don't quite understand what all of this is leading up to.
One day, as we were on our way to visit his obsession, we heard in a little house on a by street the sound of sobbing mixed with a great many tears. We asked what was going on.
Well, yes, you would, wouldn't you? I mean, you would ask what's going on, right, Tila?
A woman passing by told us two foreign women lived there in terrible conditions.
What next?
Curiosity made me drag Leandro to see what was the matter. We went into a little house to find an old woman dying.
Oh!
A nurse crying.
Oh!
And a young girl dissolved into tears. The most beautiful, the most exquisite that was ever seen. Any other girl would have looked wretched in the state she was in, wearing nothing.
What?
But rags. Her hair falling disheveled about her face. But even in that state, she glittered like a thousand stars.
Yes, well, I think I'm beginning to get the point.
If you had seen her, Scapino, in the state I found her, you would have found her devastating.
I don't doubt it. But I haven't seen her. So I realize that she must have that certain.
Worse than all this, add the poverty in which my poor, lovely wife is now in, and my inability, penniless as I am, to help her.
There!
It's only a question of asking nicely, dear Scapino.
beg you with all of my heart to be the captain of our ship.
Pardon? Yes. And you, have you nothing to say to me?
I beg you by everything that's dear to you to help us and our love.
Right, well, I have been on your ground. So you get along and I'll do some thinking on your behalf. Just get along home and don't worry about it. What a lovely girl. Oh yes, now you, get your upper lip stiffened to meet your father.
I must admit, my upper lip's trembling already. I seem to have a sort of natural cowardice that I just can't seem to overcome.
Look, you must see master from the moment your father arrived, or else he'll take advantage of your weakness and treat you like a child. You must learn to look
composed.
Composed. A little boldness, and answer him firmly, whatever he says. Right, so we'll have a little rehearsal. We have an audience. Hey. Super. Now remember, mind resolute, heavy, furrows.
Like this.
No. Head high, chin out, fur looks.
Like this.
That sounds better. Now, imagine that I'm your father, and I just arrived. Now, answer me firmly as if I were him. I'm coming out now.
Who ever heard of such a thing? What an idiot thing to do! Very worthless, notorious son of mine! Unworthy of a father like me! How dare you stand before me after this fine behavior, this cheap trick you played whilst I've been away? Is this the fruit of my loins? You lout! Say something! You have the audacity to go out and get married without your father's consent! Get married in secret! Say something, you lout! Answer me! Say something!
That's why you mustn't act like such an idiot.
I'll do better this time. I'll try to be determined. Determined. Definitely.
Good. Here comes your father.
Oh, God, I'm rough.
What a weak, mean specimen. Well, special. Looks like it's up to just you and me to deal with the old man ourselves.
What should I tell him?
Agree with what I say and back me up.
Who's ever heard of such a thing?
He's already heard about it. He's so furious, he's having a row with himself about it.
What a lunatic thing to do!
Well, let's listen a while, shall we?
I'd love to hear what they dare tell me about this damn marriage.
Well, it's funny, because we were just thinking about it.
Will they try to deny it?
No, I don't think we'll do that.
Maybe they'll try to make excuses.
That's possible.
Or maybe they'll try to entertain me with fairy stories.
Perhaps, huh? I do like that.
Everything they say will be useless.
Oh, we'll see about that.
They shan't make an idiot of me.
Don't count on it, guy.
I'll make sure that rascal Sunlight is kept safe.
And we've the same intention.
And as for that rascal Silvestro, I'll be able to...
I knew he'd remember me.
Ah, so you're there, are you? Wise custodian of family, five moral teachers of the young.
Why, sir, I am ravished to see you, sir.
How do you, Scapino? Carried out my orders prettily, haven't you?
I've done my best.
My son's being all too well lost, I've been away.
Sir, you look very well as far as I can tell.
Very pleasant. Can't you say anything, you idiot? Can't you say anything?
Sir, did you have a pleasant journey back, sir? Because I hear the scurvy and the hurricanes, it's dreadful at this time of year.
Very pleasant. Now, for God's sakes, let me have a row in peace.
You want to get a row, sir?
Yes, I want a row.
With who, sir?
With that streak there.
Oh, no. That's not my line. What? Why, sir?
You've not heard what's going on whilst I've been away?
Wow. Sir? Wow. I may have heard a few little jokey things.
Oh, a few little jokey things? A catastrophe like this?
Sir, maybe you're just hearing things a little bit differently than I am.
An astounding piece of insolence like this?
Wow.
A son to get married without his father's consent?
Yes, sir. I realize it's unusual, but I don't think that you should make such a big fuss about it.
Well, I do think I should, and I'll have my belly full of fuss about it. Don't you think I've every right in the world to be angry?
Oh, sir. Quite. And sir, I was just the same after I heard the news, and I was so incensed on your behalf that I had in on this row with your son. Why, sir, just you ask him how I shouted, how I lectured him on the respect he owed a father whose footsteps he's not good enough to kiss. Sir, you couldn't have done it better yourself, but what good does it do? So I sat down, and I thought, and I reasoned out that at the bottom of it all, he might not be so much in the wrong as one might think.
What kind of clever double talk is this? There's nothing wrong in getting married point blank to a stranger.
Sir, what would you have him do? Fate led him to it.
Ah, the easiest excuse in the world. One willing to commit the worst of crimes. Lie, cheat, steal, and kill. And only to use the excuse, fate led me to it.
Sir, you take my words far too literally. Sir, well, I meant to say sir. What I meant to say, sir, is he became fatally embroiled in his affair.
Why?
Well, sir, you can't expect him to have the intelligence you do. I mean, young folks are just so...
Young?
Exactly, sir. And having the intelligence to keep them on the straight and narrow, doing only what seems reasonable. Why? Take our young Leandro, for example.
Oh!
Despite all I've taught him, despite all my remonstrances, sir, he's often done worse than your son.
Worse than my son?
Yes!
Tell me more!
Well, sir, you were young once, weren't you, sir? And didn't you once sow the odd wild oat? Why, sir, I heard you were quite the ladies' man your day, and that once you started an attack, you would not withdraw until defenses were down.
That's true. I don't know who told you that, but it's very true.
It's very true.
You've made a point there. I'm not going to myself quite fix his tongue.
Well, sir, what would you have him do? He finds a girl who shows an effect.
where he takes after you.
To have all the women in all of him.
Yes, 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 I know.
Now, sir, he finds her enchanted. He pays her visits, whispers sweet nothings, sighs with passion. He pushes his luck. She lets herself be caught. And then, surprised with her by her parents, he is mandated off to the church and forced into marriage at gunpoint.
How does he do it?
Now, sir, would you rather he allow himself to be killed, sir? It is a far, far better thing to be married than to be dead.
Oh, bravo!
They didn't tell me it happened quite like that.
Well, just you ask him, sir. He'll give you the same answer.
Was it really by force he was married?
No.
Yes, senor.
Sir, would I tell you a lie, sir?
Well, they should have gone straight to the police and reported the assault.
Sir, that's just what he couldn't do.
Would have made it easier for me to dissolve the marriage.
Dissolve the marriage?
Yes.
You wouldn't dissolve the marriage, sir.
No?
No.
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 No!
No! What? Why shouldn't I have the satisfaction of a father to see what they've done to my son?
Well, sir, it's something he really won't agree with.
He really won't agree with?
No, sir.
My son?
Your son! Sir, do you really want him to have to confess publicly that he was so afraid, sir, that he was such a coward as to allow himself to be forced into marriage? Sir, he wouldn't be able to look anyone in the face ever again, sir. He would feel unworthy of a father like you.
That's a joke.
No, sir. Listen, he must, for his honor and yours, allow everybody to think that he married her of his own free will.
For my honor and for his, I must prove the contrary.
No, he won't do it.
He will do it. I'll force him to.
He won't do it, sir. I'm certain of it.
He will do it or I'll disinherit him.
Disinherit?
Yes.
You?
Me.
Good.
What do you mean, good?
You won't disinherit
him. No?
No.
Very funny, I won't disinherit him myself.
No.
And who's going to stop me?
You will, sir.
Me?
You will have the heart to do it.
Oh, yes, I will.
Oh, no, you won't.
I tell you, shall be done.
Oh, Philly Dean.
Oh, no, Philly Dean.
No, sir. Not only tenderness will prevail, you're just naturally two good natures.
I'm not good natured. Not at all good natured.
He's not good natured. Not at all good natured.
That can be the very levels I want to.
Oh, guys, believe me, he really is. Just wait until the second act.
Get down here, piece of spaghetti!
Spaghetti!
Go find that rascal son of mine, or I will talk to Signor Girardi about the scandal.
But there's still the matter of money.
Money! Look, there's not only EA
to consider.
Hold on. The creditors are starting to chase me down the street.
Yes, well, just you leave that to me. As for now, I'm trying to find a man who I can trust to play the part that I need. Let's see. What do we got? Too much of a man. Not enough of a man. Not a man at all. Hold it. Put your hand to the face. Senna. We are one like. Now, put your hat on one side of your head.
Charming, and we can take it that your son was brought up without a flaw?
Without a floor? Oh, without a flaw. No question of it. I should be very put out if he had done anything approaching your son's behavior.
Oh, and what if this son of yours, brought up so properly by a responsible father, had gone and done worse than mine? Eh?
Worse than... What do you mean?
What do I mean?
What are you getting at?
What I'm getting at, Signor Girante, is that people shouldn't be so quick to criticize. People who throw stones should make sure the windows are boarded up at home.
I'm not very good at riddles.
Well, then get someone to explain it to you.
You wouldn't by any chance have heard a little something about my son.
It's quite possible.
Well, spit it out then.
Well, your fellow Scapino told me the outline, but in my own fury, I missed most of the details. But I'm sure most of Naples can fill that in for you. Well, I'm off to consult the Lord, see what's the next best thing to do. Arrivederci.
Arrivederci. What can it be? A worse mess than his? I can't think of anything he could do worse.
Borrow me a wife. Must we say goodbye? Each time we part, my heart wants to die.
Marrying without a father's consent is the worst thing I can think of.
Darling, hear my prayer. Ciao.
Aha! Here's you, Father. What a delight to see you back in Naples.
Hold on! A little something to discuss with you first.
But Father, surely you'll let me embrace you.
Hold off, I told you!
But surely I'll let you show my happiness by my love.
Yes. First, we have a little something to sort out together.
Owen, what may that be?
Hold still and let me look you straight in the eye.
But Father,
look me straight in the eye.
Very well.
Scapino seems to think otherwise.
Scapino?
Aha! That makes you blush!
Did he tell you something about me?
Did he tell me? This place is not suitable to sell business like this with all these people watching. We'll sell it at home. Go there immediately. And don't talk to anyone on the way. I'll be there myself in a moment. You are a disgrace! If you brought dishonor to the good name of Girante, I'll throw you out, and you'll never darken my door again! My door's quite dark enough as it is.
How could Scapino betray me like this? A weasel who, for 100 reasons, ought to keep to himself my secrets is the first to give me away to my father? I could tear him into 1,000 pieces and feed him to the fishes.
Dear Scapino, I don't know how to thank you. Heaven smiled on me when it sent you to my help.
Aha! There you are! What ecstasy to see you again, Master Trickster!
Your servant, sir! Your servant, you fled!
Don't make cruel jokes with me!
Sir!
I'll teach you a lesson!
No! Hey, let me
in, sir! No, Octavia, don't try to stop me! Please!
Okay, calm yourself!
Sir!
Let me pay him back!
No!
What have I done, sir?
What have you done? Traitor!
Okay, I know that game.
I would.
You would?
I'm waiting.
But sir, what have I done?
You know your conscience tells you very well.
I swear, sir, I do not know.
You know very well!
Wait, Alejandro!
All right, I confess it. It was me, sir. I was the one who drank that small barrel of wine someone had given you as a gift. I was entertaining a few friends. And it was me, sir, who cut a hole in the bottom of the barrel and poured water all over the floor so that you'd think he had run out.
So it was you who drank the wine and made me scream at that servant girl, thinking she was to blame.
Yes, sir, but I do hope you'll forgive me.
I'm very glad to know about that, Scapino, but it's not what I'm after at the moment.
That's not it?
No, it's something more serious, still not determined to have it.
But sir, I can't think of anything more serious, sir.
You won't say?
All right, sir. All right, I confess it. I'm very sorry about this, sir. I am, but... Remember that small gold watch you gave me to give to that gypsy girl whom you love. And I came home and my clothes were torn and my face was bloody. And sir, I told you some thugs had beat me up and they took the watch from me.
Well?
Well, sir, it was me. I want the watch for myself.
But what could you possibly want my watch for?
To see what time it is, sir.
I'm afraid you've not hit it yet.
That's still not it.
No, criminal, it's something more serious still.
Damnation!
I was so behind me.
Do you know where you went?
Oh!
dear Scapino. Now that you need me.
I'll forgive you anything you've told me, and anything worse you've done.
No! Don't forgive me anything. Stick a knife in me. Strangle me.
Beat me with a club!
I'll enjoy every minute of it, sir. While you're killing me!
No, I beg you to save my life and save my love!
No, sir! Just get it over with quickly!
You're too deaf to me! I need your genius!
Kill me!
No!
Just kill me!
No!
Just get it off of me!
No!
Scapino! You must do something to help!
What? After the way that he insulted me?
Forget all that. I beg you, give me your help.
I joined my position to his.
Yes, but I can still feel that insult deep down here.
I'll put your pride on one side.
Scapino, are you going to abandon me? Extremity, I was wrong. I admit that.
To call me a rogue, a villain, a scoundrel.
I am more sorry than I can say.
Yes, but they hit me over the head. In public. With a sausage.
I beg your pardon with all my heart. And if that's not enough, I'll get down on my knees. There, Scapino, I beg you once again to help me.
Yes, well, get up, but next time don't be so quick with your accusations.
Will you get us out of this mess?
I will think about it.
Well, you know the time is pressing.
How much do you need?
500,000 there.
And you? This kid, I tell you, he has a great education.
200,000 lira.
Good. I will get these from your dads. Now as for yours, the plan is already set. And as for yours, old miser though he is, it'll be even easier. Your dad's not exactly what one would call an Einstein. He's the kind of fellow you can count into just about anything.
How dare you?
Now hold on, Leandro. You know there's not the slightest resemblance between you and him. And you also know very well that everybody here knows very well that the only reason he's your father to begin with is because he happened to be married to your mother.
Scapino!
All ridiculous behavior!
Sure, Scapino.
All right, Otami, we'll start to deal with your father because he's here first. Now you run and tell Silvestro to come and try. Ready to play his part, all right? On two on two. Ready?
Break!
Ah! No good sense, no consideration. To jump headlong into marriage like this, oh, the follies of the youth.
Sir! Your servants!
I'll do something, you know.
Having a little think about your son's situation, are you, sir?
I must admit, put me in a state of fury.
Well, sir, life is full of disappointments. It's best that you're prepared for.
That's true, but this foolish marriage has spoiled all my plans, and I'm not going to stand for it. And I've just been to see about getting it dissolved.
No, sir. If you'll just listen to me, I'm sure we can find another way of settling this. Besides, you know what the law in this country means, don't you? You'll be caught up in so many complications and costs.
Costs! That's true. But what other way is there?
Well, sir, I think I am. You see, I was just talking to the brother of the girl I talked to. And he's one of those toughs, you know? One of those roughnecks, sir, who just stands on the street corners, poking people on the nose, sir. Just beating people with chains. Always talking about stabbing, shooting, punching. So he stands there with a razor in his pocket. pocket, sir. He just stands there and he waits for streakers.
No!
And sir, he'd just as soon have a glass of wine as a kilt. So anyway, I gave her up talking about the marriage. And I dropped a hint to him of how easily it could be dissolved on account of the gun at the ceremony. And how your position in the city, your bank account, and your powerful friend would help you along the court. So, sir, I sit him down, I give him a proposition. And he agrees, sir, the marriage should be dissolved, providing he gets some money.
How much did he ask?
Oh, sir, at first a fantastic sum.
Tell me.
Sir, you wouldn't believe me if I did.
Well, tell me.
He said you wouldn't settle for less than 500,000 or 600,000 lira.
500 or 600? May the devil seize him. Does he think I'm an idiot?
Well, sir, that's just what I said. I said, do you think the man's an idiot? And I said, sir, he's not so much of an idiot as he looked. And so, I sit him down, and we argue a little bit. And I finally get him to agree on just enough to pay off his landlady, so he can collect his luggage. A mere 200,000 lira.
We'll go to court.
No, sir, please just think.
We'll go to court.
No, sir, don't go jumping.
I'll go to court.
Sir. Sir! You know going to court is going to cost you money.
Money. That's true. But what other way is
there? Sir, that's not to mention the little bits here and there for the greasings of palms. You give our man his money now, you sell the whole thing.
But 200,000 lira.
Yes, sir. And you'll make a profit.
Profit.
That's right, sir. A profit. You see, sir, I was just doing a quick calculation, sir. And I reckon that you will save 150,000 lira. Over and above that, without reckoning all the times wasted, anxiety, vexation, and worrying you cause yourself. Sir, even if it will save you all the cheeky things that the lawyers will write about you in Cosmo, sir, it could be worth 300,000 lira not to.
I defy any lawyer to make an idiot of me.
Yes, well, do what you will, sir, but if I were you, I would avoid the courts.
Hey, Scapino, come and show me where this rat Abgante Ottavio's father is, huh?
Sir, do you know what that is? That's the brother of the girl Ottavio here. You know, the one who stands on the street corners with
Are you deaf or something? Come and show me where this rat Agate is. I've just heard he's gonna take me to court and dissolve by law the marriage of my sister.
Now, sir, I don't know whether he plans on doing that or not, but I do know he won't pay you 200,000 lira. He says that's far too much.
Off with his head. Off with his appendages. Oh, if I find him, I'll kill him. Even if I get the chair for it.
But sir, Ottavio's father may have guts. And he might not be frightened of you.
If only he were here right now, I'd wrap my fists around his chops in no time at all. Who's that man there?
This man! That's not him. That's not him.
Are you sure it isn't a friend of Agante?
A friend? Heavens, no, sir. This man is his deadliest enemy, sir.
His deadliest enemy?
Yes, sir.
Well, you old son of a bitch, glad to meet you. So, you're a deadly enemy of this fellow Agante, huh?
Yes, sir. I'll answer for it.
Shake, Buster, shake! I give you my word, I swear on my honor. By the razor in my pocket, by all the saints, that before this day is finished, I will rid you of that sniveling scoundrel, that stool pigeon Argante. You can depend on me. Go on, come on.
But sir, violence is against the law in this country.
What do I care? What have I got to lose, huh?
Well, Ottavio's father may have friends and family who will protect him against you.
That's just what I want. If only he were here right now with all his friends and relations. Just let him get near with 30 cops. Come on, let him all come, guns and all. Come on, you guys. Fight to the finish. Come on, rats. Come on, I'll take y'all at once. I'll take you with one hand behind my back, one leg up in the air. I can take you with my ass closed. Yeah, that's right. Fight to kill. No prisoners. Come on. Bang, bang. Strangle. Worms. Chickens. If that's what you want, I'll give you your belly full. Pow, 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 pow. One down. Pow, pow. Two down.
Oh, frightened, huh? Aw.
Sir, we're on your side.
Well, that just shows what happens to anyone who gets on the wrong side of me.
And sir, that just shows you how many people can be killed for a mere 200,000 lira. Oi, man, I'm off.
Ska, ska, ska.
Pino.
Ska.
Pino.
Ska.
Pino, sir.
Ska, ska. Scarino. Scarino. Scarino.
Marcus.
I think I've changed my mind.
Sir, I'm delighted for your sake.
Let's go. I got the money right here.
No, sir. If you'll just give it to me. I mean, you can't possibly be. Not after pretending to be somebody else. I'm afraid, sir. Knowing you tricked him, he might decide to ask for more.
That's true. But I'd feel a whole lot better knowing where my money went.
Sir, don't you trust me?
No, it's not that much.
No, sir. Either I'm a scoundrel, or I'm an honest man. One or the other, sir. And if you don't trust me, well then, I'll wash my hands of the entire situation. And you can find somebody else to do your dirty work for you.
Take it.
No, I'll be very happy if you give it to somebody else.
Take it, I beg you.
No, sir. How do you know I won't trick you out of your money?
For God's sake, take it. I've been waiting for you at home.
I'll be there shortly, sir.
Ciao.
Ciao, my friend. One down, one to go.
Hey, here he comes now.
Oh, God. Haven't you really got them queuing up today? Oh, poor old fellow. Poor old Gerante. Poor old fellow. What did he do?
What's he saying about me with a face like a lemon?
Can anyone tell me where to find my very, very good friend, Signor Gerante?
What's the matter, Scapino?
I must find him so I can tell him about this terrible disaster.
What on earth is it?
I mean, I searched everywhere for him, but all in vain.
I'm here, it's me.
You are right, sir. Maybe he's hiding in the quay, and no one can find him. Sir, are you there?
Hey, are you deaf?
Sir!
What?
It's impossible to find you anyways.
I've been standing right here. What's the matter?
Sir!
Yes?
Sir, you saw
him. Come on, my son?
Well, I saw him earlier, and he was looking very upset, very unhappy over something you must have told him. In which, for no good reason, you managed to get me involved. So anyways, I take your son for a walk down the quay side. There you were, sir, just admiring the yachts. One in particular, this very cute little motorboat.
Oh,
yeah. When up comes this fellow, Turkish he was. What a delight. And so anyway, sir, he comes up, shakes our hands, and invites us on board. So on we went, sir. And sir, we ate the most beautiful food and drank wine such as you've never tasted.
And how does this make you feel so horrible?
Listen, sir, just listen. When we were on board, he orders his ship to be put to sea. And sir, when we were a good way from shore, he throws me overboard into the skiff. And he sends me to tell you that you don't send him by return by me 500,000 lira. He'll kidnap your son and take him to Algiers.
What the devil? 500,000 lira?
Yes, sir. And he only gave me 2 hours to get it.
What?
I lied, sir. Oh. 1 hour and 50 minutes.
Oh, that terrible turf would be the death of me.
Yes, sir. But please tell me, what are we going to do to save your son from a fate worse than death?
Off with you, Scapino, and tell that turf I'll send the police after him.
The police, sir? What a brilliant idea. We'll call the police. We'll call the police in the middle of the ocean. Sir, are you joking?
What the devil was he doing on board that boat?
Yes, but sir, he didn't realize this was going to happen, no, did he?
Scapino, the time has come for you to play the role of a faithful servant.
Yes, sir!
Go to that turk and tell him to send me back my son, and that I have sent you to take his place until I have enough money together.
Sir! What a brilliant idea! Genius, sir! Sir, do you really have any idea what you're talking about?
No.
Sir, do you really expect that Turk to have so little sense as to trade your son for a wretch like me?
But what the hell was he doing on board that boat?
Some people just have bad luck, sir. Now please, we only have 1.5 hours left.
And you say he asks?
500,000 lira.
500,000 lira. Has he no conscience?
Well, certainly, sir. The conscience of a Turk.
That's not funny. Does he think that money like that is just picked up in the gutter?
Some people, sir, have no business sense.
But what the devil was he doing on board that boat?
Yes, but one doesn't read fortune, does one, sir? So if you'll please just get it over with.
Here, Scapino, this is the key to my closet.
Good.
Open it.
The key?
The closet.
Oh, very good.
Inside, you'll find a little hook. On the hook, there is a large key. That is the key to my attic. Inside, you'll find a larger key, which is the key to my secret hiding hole. In there, you'll find a large brass bedstead. On the bedstead, there is a mattress. Lift it up, roll it over, and sell it to ransom my son.
Sell it, sir. You wouldn't get 100 lira for that mattress, sir. Now please think of how little time there is.
But what the devil was he doing on board that boat?
Yes, sir, but forget the boat. Because by now, your son's already gone. Oh, poor, poor fellow. I may never see you again. By now, you're halfway to Algiers, to a fate we not know.
But heaven is my witness. I've done all I can, and there's no one to blame but a hard-hearted father.
Don't strain yourself, Scapino. I'll get the money.
Hurry, sir. I tremble lest the clock strikes.
Was it 400,000 lira you said?
500,000, sir.
500,000 lira. Here's Scapino. Remember, someone gave me money today.
Of course, sir.
I never thought it would be leaving me so soon. Here, take it and ransom my son.
Sir.
But tell that Turk he's a murderer.
Yes, sir.
A scoundrel.
Certainly, sir.
A money grabber.
You can count on me, sir.
And that if I ever catch him, I'll have my revenge on him.
Sir. 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 No. Sir, the money.
I gave it to you.
No, sir. You put it back in your purple sack in your pockets.
In my purple sack?
Yes, sir. In your purple sack, right in that pocket there.
In my pocket. In my purple sack. Grief disturbs my senses.
That's plain to see, sir.
But what the devil was he doing on board that boat? Blast that boat! That terrorator will be the death of me. What the devil was he doing on board that boat? I hate turks.
Well, obviously. I'm not through with you yet, old miser. And I'll pay you back another form of coin for that tale you told about me to your son.
Well, Scapino, any news?
200,000 lira, sir.
I'm wild with happiness.
And have you done anything to save my love from disaster?
Sir, for you, I could do nothing.
Then I must end it all.
Careful, sir. One step at a time. So, yeah, there you go. Oh!
What else can I do? Life means nothing without my lovely Serenetta. I must end it all.
What's he talking about? Hold on a minute, sir. I was just joking.
Show me the money.
Here, sir. Will this sound any different?
You made life worth living.
Oh, yeah. Get him down. I got him. Any minute. No, it's cool. Take your time. Now, sir, I will only give you this money on one condition. You allow me a little bit of a revenge on your father.
Anything you like.
You swear it, sir. In front of Whitnot. Witnesses? Witnesses?
Yes!
Well, sir, 500,000 lira.
Come, let us go buy that lovely creature that I love.
My lovely Jesse.
My lovely Serenetta. Splash!
Thank you. I walk back.
See you back in
together, and I am carrying out the order that they have given me.
Such an order does nothing but please me. I am happy to have you as my companion, and it shall not be my fault if the friendship between those we love is not echoed between us two.
I agree, and I am not someone to refuse an offer of friendship.
And when that offer is love?
Love is another matter. There is a little more risk, and I'm not so brave.
Yes, well, I wish you would take that risk for my master now. What he has just done for you should make you brave enough.
What he has just done is not quite enough to convince me. We're just good friends. I may be always smiling and full of laughter, but as for my laughing, I am serious and certain.
Secrets and get away with it.
dying. Tis you must go and unspy.
But bring ye back when summer's in the meadow, and when the valley's hushed and white with snow, tis I'll be in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so.
I pose a question to you. What am I, a nice Polish boy, doing a play like this?
Are you meeting up with saving my son?
Your son! Your son is now perfectly safe. But you, sir, who now run the risk? Why, sir, you're in the greatest danger. What I would do, sir, to see you locked up safely back home.
Why?
Why, sir, at this very moment, they're searching everywhere to murder you!
Me?
Yes!
Who?
The brother of the girl Octavio married. He's just heard about your plan to put your daughter in the marriage bed reserved for his sister. Sir, he fears it will succeed. Thinking this, he's vowed to wreak vengeance on you, sir, and make you pay with your life for the slight on his family's name. Why, sir, right now, all of his friends, bullies like himself, are out searching everywhere for you, sir. Why, I saw an entire squad of soldiers, sir, beating up and questioning everyone in the town and laying siege to every way back to your house so that you can't step to the right or to the left without falling into their hands, sir.
Oh, dear Scapino, what shall I do?
Well, I don't know, sir, do I? I mean, it's a funny situation. Sir, I'm trembling from hand to mouth.
Shut up, you, or I'll stuff you!
Sir!
can kill. Ho! Hang him from the highest yardarm! Peck him to death with my parrot!
Pretty Polly!
Shut up, you!
Sir, I swear, I do not know where he is!
Jim Glenn! You don't happen to be a shipmate of his, do ye?
Yes, sir, I do ye. A very devoted shipmate.
Right then, you give this to Girante from me.
Pretty Polly!
And her too. Yar! Ah! Yar! Ah! Let that be a lesson to you, Jim. And when you see that Girante, you tell him when I find him, he'll be my little bit of treasure. And you know what a pirate does with a little bit of treasure?
He buries it.
That's right. He buries it. So now I'm off. Up sail. Up anchor. Up and away, my beautiful doubloon. Balloon. Up into the sky.
Oh, damn you, bully, sir. May they take his guts for garters.
Oh, I'm beaten to death.
Sir, my back is broken.
How is it your back that's broken? It was my back he was beating.
No, sir. That was my back he was having a go at.
Oh, no. I felt every stroke, and I feel every one of them still.
Yes, sir. That was just the end of his, yardarm, sir. That was reaching you.
Well, then you should have moved off a little bit so none of it would have reached me.
Oh, God, sir, don't look over there. Here comes another. In you go, sir, as quick as you can. That's it, sir. In you go. Oh. Not a sound. Not a move, sir. Oh, just in time. It's a real vicious Eastern type. What?
He's not over here.
goodbye, Signor Girante! Sir, I swear, I do not know where he is. Now either you tell us where we can find Signor Girante, or we'll attack yourself! Sir, I swear to you, I do not know where he is. Right then, Sergeant, prepare to charge. Sir, I'm telling you the truth, I don't know where he is. Ready, Sergeant?
Yep.
There. Okay. My lords, ladies and gentlemen, prepare to charge. Let's march. Left, right.
I told him his whole story before I realized it was him.
his own story.
Yes, I was bursting to tell someone. Oh, a bunch of Nicobio. What does it matter? Things can't get any worse for us.
Good Lord, woman. Your tongue must be long enough for two. You can't even keep your own secrets.
Oh, yeah.
Hey there, Celestial.
Get inside. That's my master calling me.
So you, that rascal Scapino, has conspired me and my sons in it too? Do you think I'm going to stand for this?
Yes.
No. No.
Look, if that scoundrel Scapino has tricked you in any way, I wash my hands of the whole affair, sir.
I'm not going to let myself be made a fool of.
Yes. No.
Ah, oh, Signor Gans, you see me weighted down by misfortune.
Ah, Signor Gianti, you see me too in the slough of despondency.
That villain Scapino has tricked me out of 500,000 lira.
That self-same criminal Scapino has cheated me out of 200,000 lira.
Not only has he tricked me out of 500,000 lira, but he's treated me in a way which I am too ashamed to discuss. But I'll pay him back for it.
I'll make sure he pays for the tricks he's played on us.
Dear God, please do not let them find out I was mixed up in all of this.
But this isn't the end of the story. One misfortune follows another. The daughter I expected to arrive today has vanished. She and her mother set out some time ago from Marseille and are reported to have been missing in the ship they sailed in.
Why did you not hear her?
Reasons. Business and family interests forced me to keep the second marriage a great secret.
Oh, Signor Pandolfo!
You hear, nurse?
Oh, Signor Pandolfo!
Don't call me Pandolfo. Call me Gironte. The reasons which forced me to take another name at Marseille exist no longer.
Alas, what trouble this change of name has caused us in trying to find you here.
Us? Then my daughter and her mother are with you?
Your daughter, Signor, is close by. But before you see her, I must beg you to forgive us. For we were penniless and starving and thought we should never see you again. I must beg you to forgive me for letting her be married.
Married? To whom?
To a young gentleman called Octavio.
God,
what a coincidence!
Quickly, take us to them.
Follow me to that house over there!
Well, I never would have believed it if I hadn't seen it with my own ears.
Well, Silvestre,
how's tricks? I've got two little bits of information for you, and one's a surprise. Ottavio's worries are over. Our Giacinta turned out to be none other than Signor Gerante's daughter.
Hey! Chichi!
Right. Lux brought about the very thing the father's most intended. The other bit of information, no surprise, is that both fathers are making terrible threats about your future, especially Signor Gerante.
Yes, well, threats never did anyone any harm, now did they? They're just clouds passing by, high in the sky.
Yes, well, just you watch yourself. I wouldn't put it past those two boys to make it up with their fathers, and then what would you be, huh?
Well, just you leave that to me.
Oh, watch yourself. Here, hide. Here they come.
Come along, my dear, come home with me. My happiness could only be complete if I had been able to see your mother with you.
Here comes Ottavio, right on cue. Here comes Ottavio, right on cue. Son, come celebrate with us the heavy occasion of your marriage.
No, father. All your plans of marriage mean nothing to me. I must be plain with you. You've heard of the secret marriage I made.
Yes, but you don't.
I know all I need to know.
I must tell you about Signor Gerante's daughter.
Signor Gerante's daughter means nothing to me. She's the one you...
No, sir!
I will not be shaken!
Just let him get
up! Shut up, you! I don't want to hear.
You're white!
No, father! I will die rather than desert my lovely Jacinta.
This is the glow to my Mary.
I'll love her all my life and never even look at another woman.
Oh, my God, what an idiot he is. He listens to no one but himself.
Father, if you knew her, you would love her as much as I do.
You expect me to allow a creature who's ensnared your brother into my house? A creature who not half an hour ago threw a thousand insults in my face?
Forgive me, forgive me. I should have never said those things if I'd known it was you. And then I only knew you by repute.
What do you mean, repute?
As the meanest group of mother. My brother's love for her is deep and true, and I will answer for her virtue.
That's all very well, but would you have me marry my son to her? Girl of the streets that nobody knows?
Father, you need no longer to claim that love girl without a name or a fortune. The gypsies who sold her to me revealed she was born in this city.
City?
And to a well-known family.
Family?
He stole her away when she was 4 years old.
Four?
And here is a bracelet that may reveal to us. That may reveal to us exactly who her real parents are.
Unbelievable! This proves that she's my very own daughter, whom I lost at the age you spoke of.
Your daughter?
Yes, and now that I look into her eyes, I see all our family's characteristics.
Father! What an extraordinary coincidence! Signore! Signore! It has been a terrible accident!
Accidente!
Poor Scapino!
Scapino!
I will see that wretch hang!
Oh, you won't have to worry about that yourself. You see, as he was passing by the scaffolding of a new building, a stolen mother's hammer fell on his head.
Oh.
Fractured his skull.
Oh.
Well, where is he?
Here he comes, right now.
Signores!
Signores! You see me now in this tragic state! Signores, before I die, I came to beg your forgiveness. Sir, my dying breath, I beg you, forgive me from the bottom of your hearts.
Si,
especially, Signor Argante and Signor Girante.
On my part, Scapino, I forgive you. Go and die in peace.
Yes!
No!
Yes!
No!
Yes!
guys enjoyed yourselves tonight, go home, tell your friends, tell your family, and Mrs. Solano, you can tell your enemies, all right? Come join the Academy of Medicine anytime. Joe! We'll see you in the lobby. Ellie, can I have a little bit of light? Go get him, guys.